Okay, so we've only got time to build up for 15. Then, all we want to show that ductwork is the size. Now this ductwork isn't insulated, so obviously we'll just show the external dimension. If we put insulation on the ductwork, we can make it have the free area of the duct, which would be obviously the external size minus the insulation thickness. So there should already be a tag loaded in. We started off with the mechanical project template, so just go right at the top, choose tag by category. Another option is to go to your annotate toolbar, go to your back toolbar, and choose the same like tag by category, and just select your duct. You can just hover over the duct and hit the space bar, tag, rotate. Also choose to turn the leader off. Place the tag next to the duct. The last 350 by 350, and that is reading obviously the width and height. Thank you. both the airflow of the diffuser and also the mask number. And that will correspond to the schedule which is already on the sheet.
Thank you.
plan altogether. I don't think it's up to you. You can have three lines in your ceiling plan or your floor plan, but for this one, I'm just going to turn them off in my ceiling plan and I'll show them in the floor plan. So let's go into a ceiling plan. I've got a view template applied to that view. And let's go down to view template. If you don't have a view template applied, just type VV. Once this window is up, you can start to turn off three lines. If you click on a grid line, you'll see you've got, I've got a box on the right. Tick. If I untick that, nothing happens. That's shoot. Or the way we've got to set up the work is, if you untick that box, the bubble disappears. And it just goes through the different options we have. That's weird. So the left side works. Okay, so the way I'm going to work this is I'm just going to drag this, click on this divide, and drag this right side all the way to the left.
Doubling up.
It's
double.
Just realize. Yep. The same process as before. We can just go into our view template for that view. And this time we want to turn off the grid lines in the electrical. So I'll go to override RGB links, edit that one, and go to display settings, click on post view. That should bring that window up.
Categories again.
Actually, before you do that,
which override was that that you're in there?
That will be your rivet links override. And select the rivet elect model. Basic display settings, select custom, and go to annotation categories, drop down to custom again, and find grid lines, turn those off. Okay, now I'll just fix this grid line up and drag this end point over to the right. And the other option I wanted to show you was that you can rotate from having grid bubble to not having one, and then you can turn the bottom one off. But if you have a row done. Back to the sheet. And start labeling the equipment and pipework. And then we'll get on to a practice exercise. We're all okay with that so far? Okay, so I'm going to start labeling my outdoor units. Two stacked on top of each other there, and one over there, and then 1, 2, 3 indoor units. So for my outdoor units, just go and do the big A right at the top, all go to annotate, and select text. For the two units that I've stacked, I'll just below the unit name, I'll specify whether it's above or below. Air conditioning unit, that just makes no sense that pipework. So I just say pipework driver within cavity wall. Bench in the laundry or in the toilet.